Tonight, Michael Jackson's friend and dermatologist, Dr. Arnold Klein, is back. 4 months after the King of Pop's death, he sets the record straight. Did he give Michael drugs? Is he the father of the kids? He'll answer questions that won't go away.
Do you ever say to yourself, I should have done something different?
Good evening. Great pleasure to welcome back to Larry King Live, Dr. Arnold Klein, the famed dermatologist who was Michael Jackson's longtime physician and friend. Also with us is Garo Ghazarian. He is Dr. Klein's criminal attorney, and Richard Charnley, who's the civil attorney for Dr. Klein. Why do you need attorneys, Arnold?
Why do I need attorneys? Why do you need doctors? It's the same reason. I mean, we live in a world where you need attorneys to protect yourself, and you need doctors to make yourself heal.
Is there a possibility of criminal charges against you?
I don't think whatsoever. I haven't broken any laws. There's no proof whatsoever that I've broken any laws. You can ask my lawyers.
Now, Garo, do you feel any criminal coming?
No, I don't. Based on everything I have done thus far, I'm fairly confident and comfortable, although this is against the general rule to have a client on the air. It goes
during
against
an
everything.
Investigation.
Yes.
That's still an ongoing investigation.
There is an ongoing investigation.
Can I just say, the people who pointed their fingers at me should really consider those people who pointed their fingers at me. I mean, how reliable, how credible were they?
Richard,
I mean,
what about the threat of civil suits?
Well, I haven't heard any civil litigation pending against Dr. Klein. I think it has been reported, and it's true, that Dr. Klein has filed some suits of his own.
Oh, against?
We have a suit right now pending against Dr. Stephen Hoffman. In connection with some statements that he made to The Sun about a month and a half ago.
We'll do more on that later. Has this impacted your practice, Dr.
Well, I mean, I will tell you one thing that, you know, I think people should know who I am. Basically, I'm a full professor, because I was looking at Dr. Ghazarian, full professor of dermatology and medicine at UCLA. Okay, I invented minimally invasive aesthetics. I think I'm the best at what I do. You know, what I deal is I'm still dealing with the FDA trying to make the FDA a better place, because if we're going to fix medicine in America...
I know, we did that last time, but I
know. Okay, has it affected my practice? Only to the degree that it's taken time away from treating my patients, which is my primary
but
purpose.
But you haven't lost patients.
Not that I know of.
What was it like to have your office searched?
It was horrible. This whole thing has been horrible.
Well, let me clarify that. His office was never searched. There were records that were sought.
Taken.
They were sought, and we provided them voluntarily. The office was never... No law enforcement agent ever set foot in his office.
Can I just say one thing? They had meetings in front of my office, but they never came into my office.
What was your reaction to the charge that it was homicide?
By Dr. Murray?
By whatever doctor.
I think that
he hasn't been charged.
He hasn't been charged at the grand jury's meeting, but I think you have to look at the picture, entire picture, and if you give a medicine without controlling it, it becomes a medical problem, a severe medical problem. So I think when you deliver a certain medication, you have to be controlling it. But this is, again, something that lawyers would answer, not something that I would answer.
Other things on a different nature, and I'll get back to this. You've never really said yes or no on fatherhood.
It's not something I'll ever answer, because you know what? It was buried with Michael. And that's not a question that I can ever answer, nor will I ever answer.
So you won't say no?
I won't answer it.
Did you ever give him drugs?
Did I ever give him medication? Well, I used to do surgical procedures on him. I gave him medication. I once gave him a muscle relaxant in the last 7 years, and that was about it, to the extent of giving him anything. I never gave him anything to take home that was addicting. I mean, I was aware that he had used propofol, this drug we talk about a lot before, which is a drug of addiction, and people don't know, and it's very poorly controlled by the government.
That's usually given in different circumstances.
It's given under anesthesia by someone with proper monitoring.
Did you ever tell Michael, as his friend, to get help?
I made two interventions on Michael myself. Made an intervention on Michael in Las Vegas. I flew to Las Vegas to intervene and threw the doctors out of the room when they were giving him drugs. And I also did a second intervention on him after he appeared in Mexico and got him help. And he went at that point to England and withdrew. So I made him very much aware that in the 90s, he'd been given a great deal of propofol by a physician. And I, you know, went through a whole situation with him and told him this was a very dangerous drug, that it was addicting.
You agree it was homicide?
It's very hard for me to say because I wasn't there, but I feel if a doctor gives a patient inappropriate things, I can't use the term homicide.
What is the correct
term? Homicide is the death of a human being.
I don't want to involve any named doctor.
No, the definition of homicide is death of a human being by another, which means proximately caused by another. In order to determine that, one needs to have the entire set of facts before him or her to make a judgment call. I don't think Dr. Klein or any one of us here has the entire set of facts. That's why I believe the grand jury is convening to determine if charges ought to be filed and against whom, if any.
Was he addicted?
I mean, you can be addicted to propofol. It can be an addicting drug. And it's an addicting drug that usually you see mostly among doctors and nurses because they have the adequate equipment to giving it to you. I did not know that he was giving propofol. So you asked me if he was addicted. I had no idea he was
addicted.
There's
a time context, Larry, because when you say, was he addicted, a person may be addicted in 1993, recover from the addiction, and move on.
And still call an addict.
And be still called an addict. Doesn't mean that they are a practicing addict, obviously. So one may go beyond what one was once. I believe Dr. Klein is talking about in the 90s, mid-90s or thereabouts, about some issues that he had intervened with.
Bill Wilson, who founded AA, who I know, because I wrote a book on heroin addiction when I first met him, when you talk to someone who's an addict, you've always talked about someone recovering. But propofol is not a drug that we commonly see addicted. It's now being abused more than everything ever since it's been mentioned.
How do you go get it?
You get it by prescription. It's not really controlled that well, but you must be controlled with what's called a pulse oximeter, knowing the heart rate and all those things while you use it.
Do you think, Dr. Klein, that he could have done 50 concerts?
I think he was in great physical condition. I think the autopsy showed that he was in great physical condition. And I think he was, you know, he was not this person without a nose that was portrayed initially in the press. The press has been hysterical, and the press has been so sensational about me, about everything. And there's no truth in the press anymore. I mean, there's no truth anywhere anymore in what you read. So I think he was totally capable of doing this. But they wanted to show him as a meek individual. Michael was far from meek. Michael was probably one of the most talented, strong people I've ever met.
Richard, is Dr. Klein in any civil trouble?
No, I don't think he's in any civil trouble. I don't think there's any connection between any procedures or medical care that was given by Dr. Klein in the several months leading up to Michael Jackson's death and the actual cause of death. And that would be the threshold that one would look at to determine.
Got it. Garo, has anyone officially said to you he is cleared?
No, no one has said so, but silence speaks for itself as well. I will reserve judgment, but I have continued on with my duties, and the more I have uncovered, the more I have felt comfortable.
Have I been helpful with the investigation?
Well, you know, Dr. Klein has been more than any client.
Would you say you'd be shocked if he was charged with anything?
I would be shocked. Yes.
We'll take a break. We'll be right back with Arnold Klein and Dr. Klein and Garo Ghazarian and Richard Charnley.